Hello and welcome to the 34th video in this beginner's guide to Adobe After Effects. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how to create a simple bouncing pin animation in After Effects. So in the previous episode, we made a start on our video presentation, where we animated some type and a background image. In this video, we are going to continue on and add the next animation element. In this video, I'm going to show you how to animate a bouncing pin like this, which we will then add to complete the first part of the intro animation sequence. So in this video, we will be covering the following topics: animating a graphic, and animating position, scale, and opacity. So let's get into it. So here I am where we left off in the previous episode, where we animated a type layer and a background image. Now, if you're following along for the first time, I suggest going back to the previous episode, where we set up this document and animated the first sequence. Now, if you are continuing on from the last episode, make sure you have your document open ready. With our document open, let's proceed. So looking back at the Photoshop design, in frame 1 in the layers panel, we can see these 5 destination pins around the type. So let's go ahead and put these in. So back in After Effects, we are going to bring in a new media element. So with the project folder open, click into folder 2, project assets, and then into the images folder, then into the AI folder, then into the objects folder, and you will see a file called pin.ai. Now, simply click and drag the pin file into the project panel in After Effects. Upon release, we will see our new image asset ready to use. So I'll quickly drag this new image into the assets folder, then into the images folder, and into the vector folder because it's an AI file, an Illustrator file. So with the asset selected in the project panel, press Command/ on Mac or Control/ on PC. This will place the image into the comp and at the top of the layer stack in the timeline panel. So looking in the timeline panel, we can see that this is an Illustrator layer because we can see the Illustrator file icon next to the name. And right now the color of the pin is black. So this is a graphic that has been prepared using Adobe Illustrator. Now in After Effects, we can convert this to a shape. So I'll come down and right click on the layer. I'll come over to Create and select Create Shapes from Vector Layer. Upon click, a new shape layer will appear and the previous layer below will toggle off. For now, we can select the layer below and simply delete it. Next, I will select the new pin shape layer and press Enter. This will allow me to change the name of the layer, and I'll rename this layer to Pin. So now, if I select the new shape layer, I can come up to the top menu, click on the fill color box and select a white color and click OK. And now we have our pin graphic to work with. So now I can click on my pin with the selection tool and place it wherever I want. However, I am not going to do that right now. So I'll press Command-Z on Mac or Control-Z on PC to put it back in the middle. What I'm going to do next is create the first animation. What I want are 5 icons to appear into the frame around the type. So what I'm going to do here is animate one pin and then duplicate it a bunch of times. Okay, so let's start by animating the pin. Now right now, I just want to focus on this one graphic here, so I'm going to turn it into a pre-comp. So with the layer selected, I'm going to right-click and select Pre-compose. Upon click, the settings will appear. So I'm going to name this pin, then I'm going to select move all attributes into the new comp. For now, I'll select adjust composition duration to the time span of the selected layer, and I'll check open in new composition, and I'll click OK. Upon click, we will now open a new comp with just my white pin inside. And in the project panel, we can see our new comp appear. So the first thing I'm going to do is shorten down the duration of this comp. Right now, it's 1 minute 20 seconds, and that's far too long. So I'll press Command-K on Mac or Control-K on PC, and this will bring up the composition settings. So down in the duration, I'll change this from 1 minute 20 seconds to 5 seconds and click OK. So if we select the pin layer, right now the anchor point is around the middle of the shape. For the animation I'm about to create, I need this anchor point to be set at the baseline, right at the bottom point of the pin. So with the pin selected, I'll come up to the Tools menu and select the Anchor Point tool. Then I'll come and carefully click and drag the anchor point down to the baseline and in the middle, like so, right at the point here. Next, with the layer still selected, I'll press S to activate the scale settings and just drag up like so. And you will see, because we placed the anchor point at the base, when it scales from the bottom, where the anchor point is. Nice. So now my pin is ready to animate. So what I want to do here is have the pin fall from above with a little rubber bounce effect when it lands. So I'll zoom in on the pin. I'll press Command R on Mac or Control R on PC to activate the rulers, and I'll drag a guide from the top and down right to the baseline of the point. And I'll also make sure the pin is nicely aligned center to the guides. Perfect. So I'm going to start with position. So I'll drag my time indicator right to the start of the comp, and I'll press P to activate position. I'll come down and click on the stopwatch to place my first keyframe for position. So next, I'll click on the zoom into frame level switch and drag that all the way right. Now, we have zoomed so far into the timeline, we can now see the individual frames. So I'll move my time indicator across the timeline so it's placed at the sixth frame, and then come and click on the diamond icon to drop a new keyframe for position. So if I zoom out here, we can see that the time between these two keyframes is quite short, just a matter of frames here. So I'll zoom back in to focus on my keyframes. With my second keyframe in place, I'm going to drag my time indicator back over my first keyframe and make sure it's on top of the first keyframe. Then I'll click on my pin, press and hold shift on the keyboard and press up about 10 times. And this is where I want the pin to start. Now, as I drag my time indicator across to the next keyframe, this is where I want my pin to land. So now I'm going to drag my time indicator a little further on from the second keyframe, and I'll press N on the keyboard. This will set the work area around these two keyframes. So I'll click somewhere in the work area and press spacebar to activate preview. And we can have a quick look at this animation, and that is looking just fine. So I'll press spacebar to stop. So what I want to do now is add a little bounce effect when it lands. So I'll place my time indicator right over the second keyframe. I'll press S to activate the scale settings, and I'll click the stopwatch to place down a keyframe for scale. So I'll move my time indicator across to frame 10, then I'll come up into the composition panel and click on the top center square on the bounding box and drag down like so. Upon dragging, we will add a new keyframe automatically for scale. So next, I'll drag my time indicator across a little further to the 14th frame. Then I'll select my first scale keyframe, press Command C on Mac or Control C on PC to copy, and then press Command V on Mac or Control V on PC to paste. Upon pasting, a new keyframe will appear where my time indicator is, and the pin will go back to the original size. So if I drag my time indicator over the keyframes, we can see the effect that is having. First, it falls, and when it lands, it has a little bounce effect. So I'll press spacebar to activate preview, and that is looking pretty cool. So I'll press spacebar to stop, and what I want to do next is have the pin fade in as it falls. So I'll drag my time indicator to the first frame for scale. I'll press T on the keyboard to activate the opacity settings. I'll click the stopwatch to drop down my first opacity keyframe, then I'll drag the time indicator right back to the start. Next, I'll click and drag the opacity settings right back to zero, and I'll press spacebar to activate preview, and now the pin fades in as it falls. So I'll press spacebar to stop, and now I'll select the layer and press U. This will now show me all the keyframes I have applied to the layer. Now this animation is almost complete. What I will do now is smooth out some of the animation with some easing. So I'll press spacebar to activate preview, and we can see that the animation is a bit rigid. So I'll press spacebar to stop, and I'll come down and focus on the position keyframes. So I'll right click on the first position keyframe, I'll come down to keyframe assistant and add easy ease out. Then I'll right click on the second position keyframe, I'll come down to keyframe assistant and add easy ease in. Next, I'll click on the second scale keyframe, I'll right click, I'll come down to keyframe assistant and add easy ease. Then I'll select the last scale keyframe, I'll right click, I'll come down to keyframe assistant and add easy ease in. So I'll press spacebar to activate preview, and we can see that the animation sequence is much more fluid. Perfect! And I'll press spacebar to stop. So now there is one last thing I'm going to do to this animation, and that is to add motion blur. Now I'll come down to the bottom corner of the interface and make sure that the layer and switches icon is activated, the first one on the left. What we need to see here is this stacked circular icon here. So on this pin layer, I'll come across and click the square just under the circle stack icon. This is the motion blur icon. With this clicked, motion blur will be applied. Now also, we will need to click the motion blur icon located on the top of the timeline panel. This will enable the effect to work. So I'll press spacebar to activate preview, and now we can see a very subtle motion blur as the pin falls. Perfect. And I'll press spacebar to stop. So now I'll come and click back on the main comp tab, and back in the main comp, we can now see this new pin comp layer in the timeline. And if we look over in the project panel, we can see the pin comp. So I'll select the pin comp layer in the project panel and drag it up and place it into the pre-comps folder. Next, I'll come down and click on the colored square for my comp layer and select blue. So looking back at the Photoshop design, we can see where I have positioned them and to what size. So back in After Effects, I'll select my pin comp layer and press S to activate the scale settings for the layer. And I'll come and drag the scale down to around 40%. Next, with the selection tool, I'll click and drag my pin into the first position, taking reference from my Photoshop design. Okay, so now I need another four of these. So with the layer selected, I'll press Command D on Mac or Control D on PC to duplicate the layer. With the new layer in the timeline panel, I'll click and drag it into the next position, taking reference from my Photoshop document. So now I need another three of these. So with the layer selected, I'll press Command D on Mac or Control D on PC to duplicate the layer. With the new layer in the timeline panel, I'll click and drag it into the next position, taking reference from my Photoshop design. So using this technique, I'm going to duplicate the layer a further two times and position them in place, taking reference from my Photoshop document. So now we have five pins that are in position. And if I scrub the timeline indicator over these layers, we can see that all five pins bounce in at the same time. Now, I want these pins to animate in at various intervals. So what I can do here is simply click and drag each pin comp layer and drag it further across the timeline at various points so as the animations start and end at different times. So I'll drag them across one at a time until I have something that looks like this. And now we can see these layers are starting at various times. So I'll drag the time indicator to the start of the timeline and press spacebar to activate preview. And now we can see the pins are animating in at various times. Perfect! So this is the first part of the introduction section covered. At this point, I would recommend saving your document so we can continue in the next episode. Now looking back at the Photoshop design, if we toggle off the visibility of frame 1 in the layers panel, we can look at frame 2. So frame 2 uses the same type style and map background, but set on a red color instead of the blue. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to animate a simple transition from frame 1 to frame 2. So see you in the next video.